All right, it is Saturday, October 7, 2023. I'm here in downtown San Bernardino, California for the Rendezvous Back to Route 66 event, which I believe used to be called Route 66 Rendezvous. This has been going on for I don't know how many years under both names. It's a big car show with a lot of cruising, so they have the loop around downtown closed off for the cruisers, which we filmed other shows with this sort of layout before, and it's always a lot of fun, always a lot of great shots that I can get. All the cars are cruising by, and it's going to be a scorcher today. It's going to get almost 100 degrees, so let's go get started. All right, so tomorrow I am still planning on doing the Long Beach swap meet in the morning, as I do most months. There's actually a lot of great events this weekend. Somebody asked me if I was going to shoot the Bellflower show today. I don't think I'm going to be able to make it out to that one, as I do have, I have to pick up my daughter later again. And that's a story in itself, because I wasn't supposed to have her this weekend. Unfortunately, she's at her friend's house right now, so I was able to come out here and shoot this one. So next week I'm off to Palm Springs for casual concours out there on Saturday. And my mother, my sister, and my daughter are going. And at the show will be the my sister's former 1948 Chrysler, which she sold to someone who said they're going to have it at the show. So there'll be a reunion for my sister and her 48 Chrysler that she sold, I guess, about a few months ago. All right, on the 21st, there's literally like three shows I want to hit, so I haven't decided which one to do yet. It's one of those ones where I have to pick and choose. And on the 22nd, I've got the big In-N-Out 75th anniversary show at Pomona Fairplex. And coming up like the last weekend of the month, right now I haven't decided yet. I think there's like a Hearst show in Whittier. I might hit that. And then on actual Halloween, I'll be at Las Vegas for SEMA. Bring you that show. Announced in the last video I did sign up for Hot Rod Power Tour West, which was I think announced about a week ago, and I signed up for the long haul, which is basically just Irwindale to Las Vegas to and then the last day is going to be Pomona again, so I'm planning on taking my 90 Fox body on that. As always, I post the tentative list of events I'm planning on hitting, which will be in the comment section pinned to the top shortly after the video posts. That's usually what I'm planning on hitting. So I always say it's tentative list. Sometimes I add to it, sometimes there might be something I miss since life happens. Look at this, some of these bombs here in Lowriders. I think Hot Rod Power Tour should be a great one to do. Look at this 64. I was not able to make it out to a car show last weekend. It just wasn't in the cards. I'll try to at least bring you two events this weekend. Just a reminder, when I do these cruising events, often you will see the same vehicle several times, especially if it's cruising around or moved. I try to get all the vehicles I can. Obviously, since the cars generally are moving around, it's not always possible. But I do try. And believe it or not, the show goes on for 12 hours. It goes 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. It is a huge deal here in San Bernardino. Obviously, I cannot stay for the entire event. definitely worth checking out if you happen to be in the area. That's 51 Mercury. There's a 40 Deluxe. I said there's one at every car show, and there it is. So we'll get this one out of the way very quickly in the video. Might see another one later on. Your 90s car show throwback of the day. There's literally like a few weekends coming up where there's like several shows I have to pick or choose from that look pretty good. And there are weekends when there's really hardly anything. I will say I was working on the old Cutlass I picked up for my daughter. It has a blown head gasket, and I'm actually trying to sell it. It's a four-door 1970, and tell you what, there's a lot of interesting people replying to car ads these days. That's about all I'm going to say about that. I finally did get one guy to come out and really inspect the car, and then I think he realized it was really good and he wasn't going to be able to talk me down much because of how good it is. Like, the body is extremely straight and rust free. I even put a jack next to it, said go under there and have a look. It has no rust, so. And he honestly couldn't believe how clean the car was. So if it doesn't sell, I might try to stash it somewhere until I can get to it. Not a Kaiser Henry J with a blower. Or if you're looking for a really interesting four-door Cutlass project that has an amazingly straight and rust-free body, let me know. It'd be perfect for like an LS swap or 455 swap or whatnot. A very clean Dodge Dart swinger for the Mopar crowd. My goal was to get the air on the DJ booth before the DJ started, and I failed miserably at that. After the Radwood crowd, how about an 85 Porsche 911? Have a fire truck going through. And his Dodge military vehicle. There's a Willis Jeep, World War II era. Oldsmobile, speaking of Oldsmobile. This guy, the original invoice, $35.83 and 77 cents back in 55. It's a Dart, not a Duster. Rod Chevy Fleet Line.
That looks good, Bob. That looks good. Yeah, I mean, it's a little bubbly.
Got the water bag. You might need it today on this Packard. I was looking on the thing. There's actually a parking lot they have set aside to cool your car down if you're on the cruise route. So I'm sure several cars will be using that. Mercury Cougar with a 5.0 HO motor. A 65 Chevelle. Yeah, the cars do move around a lot. 41 Chevy. A disco era Corvette, crossfire injection. '64 GTO. I'll say if you are looking to buy a car on Facebook Marketplace or OfferUp, never use the "Is this available?" button. Most sellers have learned to ignore those by now. Charger SE. More and more cars are starting to filter in. Very clean Chevy. If you like trucks and you haven't checked out the Grand National Truck Show video yet, it's on the channel a few weeks ago in Pomona. So I had to shot that one instead of the Ontario Cruising Reunion that day. So I'm glad I'm able to bring you another cruising show so soon afterwards. Square body. Yeah. super clean, like 80s Ford Ranger. Can't imagine there's very many left in this condition. It's a 64 Malibu. Super sport. Passing a fire department, Seagrave fire truck, where I'm out in Pasadena. Coronet. Get on YouTube. This 70 El Camino. It is for sale. Remember the swap meet rules. I've done a swap meet video in a minute. I'm going to check the date of the video. There's no phone number anyway, but it's 18,000. May do a video on like just etiquette when you're buying cars online, especially after the horrid experience I've had trying to sell the Cutlass. Let me put it this way. I had a guy ask me, he actually sent me a number and I thought he was asking if that was the engine size, and he meant he was offering that much for the car. That's all I'm going to say about that. So definitely some interesting and cheap people out there shopping for vehicles. Definitely coming out now. I say these are my favorite types of shows to film. So you get the nice moving shots of the cars going by, as well as the ones that are stationary. It is a lot of walking though. Coupe de Ville. This big Cadillac. This was about a 69 Thunderbird or so.
I saw the yellow car. I was like,
Had one of these with the four-door variety many years ago.
Yeah, woke up, got my exercise this morning, woke up, got out of bed.
He's got to show the Buick Riviera's. Very clean example.
Come on, it sounds like a...
I did do a video last week on the letters they sent out to some classic car owners asking how much they drive their cars, where they store it, things like that. So there was like a Hemmings article talking about, I guess they talked to CARB about what it was about, and so I made a little video on it since the channel started out as really a preservation, auto classic car preservation channel, including trying to get the smog gear moved up. So I really don't know how that video would do, or it's something different from kind of my videos nowadays, doing these car events. 58 Buick here. Very nicely patinaed, and not a car you see very often. But it actually got a huge response, which was... Of course, it's a video that's mainly of interest to folks in California. So I might start doing more, if there's like classic car news or anything of interest, I might start doing similar midweek videos similar to that and kind of see how that goes. Since I mean for the longest time I've been looking for something I could do midweek on the channel that would be of interest to folks who watch the car show videos. But I just felt that was definitely something that would be of interest to folks who watch the channel. That video did actually bring new people into the channel. So if you recently subscribed, welcome. And if you haven't subscribed yet, be sure to do so, because I'm always bringing you these great car events, and then hopefully now some car news. There's your body Monte Carlos, who's got the aero window. A Volkswagen Karmann Ghia. If you like Volkswagens, check out the VW Treffen video from, what, three weeks ago. A 1961 and older Volkswagens, and a lot of very interesting, rare examples of early Beetles and Karmann Ghias, transporters, things like that. Lowrider 66 Galaxy. Buick Skylark Grand Sport. I also started filling in the tentative list into 2024, so I'm still looking up event dates for next year. Someone actually commented, I guess I hadn't realized I put 2023 for the next year dates, so I went back and I fixed that. It's Impala SS. Impala. Actually, yesterday I was up the street from my house getting gas, and I ran into a guy who's a viewer who was actually filling up his 65 Impala. So, the 67. A convertible. A 64 Galaxy 500. C10. Pontiac Bonneville, all the full-size GM fans. nice Suburban. Sedan delivery. The interesting Oldsmobile. It was a 1940 model. That's 59 Chevy pickup with the six. Bodies. Nice F-100. C10. Got this OBS Chevy. Got Side roads here. Got the steering wheel and the shift lever on this one. It's an OBS truck. Actually, the cars are still rolling in to enter the show. The oldest car we've seen so far. Ford. Pair of 66 Impalas. So these cars, I imagine, roll in for the rest of the day, because as you can imagine, spending 12 hours at a car show would be quite the feat for just about anyone.
Mike.
Yeah.
So, you want to
me? I do. come on a swap meet.
I donated to you, man.
Oh, thanks. Okay.
Yeah. I love all your videos.
All right, thank you. At Pontiac Grand Prix with the 8 lugs. '68 Caprice, 396 car, the Hideaways. Got the paint on this Regal. '62 Caddy. Ford pickup with a extended cab and a dump bed. Checked them at 6,300 steps so far today. I've actually been hitting over 10,000 steps even on days that I'm not filming. I've actually made a point to go out and walk, which has also helped with my stamina when I am filming these show videos. That's 55 Pontiac rolling through. part where they enter the show. I believe you can come in and enter your car. You have to check the website, I think, for most of the day. Out here for this show today. This LS SWAT Regal Lowrider.
Yeah, that way, because I do. I work, and then on top of trying to maintain
full custom paint.
So I respect that, man. I'm just telling that way. Where they're registering over there in the background. A couple cars looks like they're cooling off.
1965 Porsche 911.
Alright, here we got the Bullet Mustang for all the Steve McQueen fans. Getting ready to head out with the family in the 64. Sharp Camaro, that old Valiant convertible we saw rolling in earlier. Thank you. cruising. Got a lot more cars coming out. It is getting hotter too.
Thank you.
1960 Mercury. You never see these.
Pass your shade.
What?
We got an American Motors product, it's the Ambassador. I just checked the weather report. It's currently 92 here, and it's supposed to hit 98 by 3 p.m. So obviously I've been filming for quite some time already. And I've had three waters, so I'm definitely staying hydrated, as you should on a hot day. Just Pontiac Le Mans. Custom 55 Buick. Check out that nail head there. A 56 Thunderbird. Two Galaxy pack and a 406. And a 4-speed.
Thank you.
Gassers. I will be at the Nitro Revival, and they've actually provided a press pass to me this year, so big thanks to those guys, and I'll be out there filming that. So we do have a lot of great events coming up. I think I was at the VW Treffen show. Got enough Corvettes in this video, so here's a Corvette. It's that 57 Ford pickup we saw there with the mean chop on it. That is definitely a custom. Smell some coolants. Trying to figure out which car it's coming from. Definitely somebody's overheating. After I made the comment about smelling a car overheating, my camera overheated. It's a hot day. Usually it's the battery that overheats, but you gotta let the camera cool down a little bit as well.
The tires are going back.
A Lincoln Town Car. I just found a 2002 for my mother that I'm gonna probably be working on this week. Yeah. Oh, there we are. You're on YouTube. You're on YouTube.
I see your videos all the time.
Oh, thanks.
What's up, man?
Okay.
You shot my car before. It's got the wood bed in it.
Oh, yeah, the wood bed.
Yeah.
We'll get it again. There you go, the wood bed. El Camino thing is pretty wild. Driving a Camaro these days. News to me. Our Model 2 shot, because why not? Thank you.
Those guys, a viewer, he wanted to get in on the action here.
Yeah.
All right. We got you. That's going to wrap things up here in San Bernardino for Rendezvous Back to Route 66, formerly Route 66 Rendezvous. I'm just as confused as you are. Lots of great cars at this one. It is very, very hot here. I am burning up. I've been here 5 hours filming. Lots of great events coming up for the channel, starting with Long Beach Swap Meet tomorrow morning. I'll be out there filming that one. Next week, we got Pomona Swap Meet and Casual Concours in Palm Springs. So lots of driving for me. Be sure to like, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Let me know what your favorite car was, and until next time, I'll be seeing you.